At Our Lady of Mount Carmel Primary School, Kate, a graduate teacher, plans a mathematics lesson on number patterns. She builds on and expands the students' learning opportunities by focusing this lesson around the use of ICT.
All right, everyone have a look at this hundreds board for me. And who can find all the patterns in here? Just have a think before you put your hand up. Have a think. How many patterns can you see? What kind of pattern? Alright, Tika, name a pattern for me.
In the twos, like 2, 4, 6, 8.
Yep, good, that's a pattern, good. Harriet?
Tens.
Mm-hmm. How does tens go again?
10, 20, 30.
Yep, good. Harry?
Threes, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15.
Okay, Harry, can you go and choose a colour on the side for me and colour in that pattern for me? So you just have to choose one of those colours and colour in the pattern you just told me. So we've got 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. All right, that will do. Thanks, Harry. So for the first iPad app, it was looking at dot-to-dot number sequencing. So I set that up myself, and I went in and made an account for each of the iPads. And set it as so only 4 and 9 times tables could be shown. The second one was a hundreds number board with all the numbers modelled up onto the side. And again, I told them to do the 4s and the 9s, so they picked either the 4s or the 9s, and they had to put the numbers onto that number board appropriately. So they could drag the 4, then they could drag the 8, and they could drag the 12. And another boy said, I didn't know this, but you could actually, if you couldn't remember what comes next, but you remember the one after that, you could actually drag it. So for 28, for instance, and then come back to the 24. So that was the other activity. The third computer activity was the dog and the bone one, where they just give a blank number board, hundreds board, displays a number on the side, say 13, and they have to try to find that within the number board as quickly as they can. So it's working on timing and also strategies that they could, like the quickest strategy they could find, so they could find the number. And the third one was a counting game as well, also 4s and 9s. They had to pick 4s and 9s and simply just click the right number to count in the right order, which were all months up. So those were the 4 activities.
What role does ICT play in your current teaching practice? How would you integrate ICT into your future planning and teaching? What supports do you think you need to help you to do this?